Hey guys, so today in this country, in the United States of America, is Thanksgiving, and it's an interesting holiday, and I just thought to share my thoughts and my experiences of Thanksgiving. It's all this time I had the YouTube channel. It's something I've never talked about, so I guess I'll start now. It's a holiday that I've really never had a good connection to. I was born in Korea and was in Korea until I was like 10 years old. This is a very American holiday, something I've never really celebrated before I came to America. We, in the Korean culture, at least my family, we celebrated something similar with the theme of, you know, giving thanks and being grateful and eating tons of food and gathering with the families. If that's the theme of American Thanksgiving, we have that in Korea. It was a different holiday. It's like Harvest Moon Festival or something like that. I don't really know how it would be translated in English, but in Korean it was called Chuseok. And I'm not sure if it's around this time of the year. It might be August, actually. Or around November, I think. I'm not sure. Also, with my family in particular, there was always a religious component to it because my dad's being a pastor and all. But yeah, that's pretty much been my experience with this kind of holiday since I was young. You know, this is like one time of the year where it's a holiday. We gather together as a family, you know, grandparents, aunts, uncles, all of us gather together. And same thing with New Year's. New Year's is really big thing in Korea, but this holiday also. And we gather together, we get a bunch of food, and the food are different. You know, of course, it's a Korean culture different, so it's not like, you know, the whole emphasis on turkey, cranberry sauce, corn, and things like that. That's American focus. With Korean focus, it was more on like fruits, big on apples and grapes and things of that nature. Fruits are a big part of it. We also have these pancake, Korean scallion pancake kind of things that we do. A lot of these cakes, don't really know how to translate them into English. But yeah, there's a big emphasis on food. And with religion, it was kind of like, you know, giving your thanks to God and presenting all those. And that tradition has a history back to like the Eastern religions, you know, Buddhism and Taoism, where, you know, you commemorate the dead by placing all this food on, and so that the dead spirits can come and have a feast, you know. So it's that kind of thing. That feast aspect has been transformed in Christianity to commemorate or give thanks to God of the plentiful harvest that's been. Anyway, that's kind of like my cultural family background. After coming to America, Thanksgiving was like, we celebrated like a little bit. You know, we would meet families here. My dad would have friends in America, and we would kind of hang out with them, and it would still be very religious kind of thing. And also, my family, even in America, didn't really have that kind of a strong connection to Thanksgiving, mostly because my mom's a nurse. And so on holidays, on Thanksgiving, she would be working. So it would be, you know, some like the day after or days after in which we would kind of get together and, you know, celebrate it. And we would really usually celebrate it in like a church setting. And because in America, most of our family members are in Korea, and we were the only family members that came here in America, this whole idea of this big family gathering didn't really happen. This whole big family gathering would happen with our church members. You know, it wouldn't be on the day of Thanksgiving, but it would be in remembrance of the Thanksgiving weekend. So the church would get together, and we would pray together, have service together, eat together, and then also have that, because it's a Korean congregation, we still have keep the tradition of putting all these food out and, you know, giving a feast and thanksgiving to the Lord and having a feast and eating that, all that stuff. So that's really been my experience with just keeping the traditions. After I went to college, you know, after I turned 17, I went to college across the country. My parents at the time were living in California. I went to New York. So there's this big separation. when Thanksgiving time hits, you know, as a student, the college gives me, NYU gave me a break time. You know, I have from Thursday and Friday off, but I still have to go back to school starting Monday. So I only have 4 days off. That usually was not enough time for me to just get a plane ticket, go back to California, and celebrate the time. I normally, I usually didn't celebrate Thanksgiving with my family after I went to college. After that, what happened was I ended up crashing on other people's Thanksgiving. One time I went to Pennsylvania, because my best friend has family there, and I celebrated their Thanksgiving. And it was really great. His mom makes great meatloaf, by the way. And that was before I was a vegetarian. Now it's a little bit trickier because of that, because of the fact that I'm vegan. So I usually went to other people's. I'm trying to remember. Last year, I actually, I don't even know how this happened, but I was working as a canvasser, campaigning for ENDA, Employment Non-Discrimination Act, fighting for gay rights and things like that. And it turned out like we got a day off for Thanksgiving as canvassing, but that's really it. The week after we would have to go back to canvassing, so there was really no time to visit my family in Tennessee. So I stayed in the city, and it turns out like a lot of my coworkers were also staying in the city and not visiting their family, so we decided to have our own Thanksgiving. And so I went to my boss's Thanksgiving dinner. My boss is the director, and it turned out awesome for me because her boyfriend is a vegan. So we had a vegan Thanksgiving, and it was pretty amazing. I went over to her apartment, and also her boyfriend's apartment, because they lived together, and we had a great vegan feast, and we got a really great discussion about like politics and things like that, because we're canvassers. So we're very idealistic, very ambitious. It's an interesting time to remember, I think, because it's now I'm not a canvasser anymore. That kind of scene has totally passed by for me. But it's interesting to think back. The year before that, I didn't celebrate Thanksgiving at all, actually. I was working in a homeless shelter, and I worked, actually, at the shelter. And that was kind of sad, but I felt really, really good that I was there with the folks, you know, who didn't really have a home or a family to go to celebrate Thanksgiving. So they celebrated amongst themselves in a shelter. That was quite, you know, a sombering thing to be a part of. And it's also, like, it's sad, though. Like, you know, when we have this holiday that, like, so focuses on, like, all the family get together and just overindulge on consumerism and just overeat, and that's celebrated. With that kind of holiday, we have these really, it's a men's shelter, older gentlemen who really don't have many ties to their family members anymore, who have no economical means to celebrate, no money to spend, you know, and just no home of their own, no privacy of their own to have this kind of family gathering. Just kind of being there with them. You know, a lot of them were in the TV room watching the football game, and the shelter also tried to provide them a Thanksgiving dinner, which was nice. But that was very sombering. My thoughts on Thanksgiving, it's kind of, I have a very mixed, because the history of Thanksgiving is, it's pretty, you know, it's not a nice history. It's a pretty recent history. It happened with, somehow there was a movement to make a holiday commemorating the pilgrims and all that, and it was presented to Abraham Lincoln, and Abraham Lincoln agreed to make it into a national holiday. It was a big movement. I think I read a book about this history of Thanksgiving, but I don't remember much of the details, so I'll probably have to read up on it again. It's a very interesting history, but it's, you know, what we are taught, because, you know, I was in America since I came to America as a 10-year-old, so I did have some American education about Thanksgiving. And in elementary schools, it's a weird, I remember, like, my third grade class, we did all this stuff with, like, Indian feathers and drawing, coloring in turkeys. Like, it's weird that, like, to me, that's what kids are taught about Thanksgiving in this country. Whereas, it's like, the history of it is actually much more complex. There's a lot more debates about the whole, you know, pilgrims and the relationship with the natives in America, and even like the story of someone like Squanto, is a quite a fascinating story, and one that I think as an American you might feel a lot of guilt over, you know, learning the full history of it. And some people, now there's a movement where Thanksgiving should really be considered like un-Thanksgiving or a day of mourning, which I guess I respect that kind of concept as well. But to me, I think it's, to me, it's just time. I get some days off. I get some days to relax. And today I'm actually, again, I'm crashing on somebody else's Thanksgiving. My friend is going to celebrate her friends, you know, in New Jersey. They're celebrating a Thanksgiving dinner with the friend's mom. I'm going over there, so that's how I'm doing it. I'm not really sure what I can eat because I'm vegan, and they're going to have a traditional Thanksgiving. So I'll probably have to eat something before I go, but I'm bringing some alcohol, so that should be fun. But yeah, that's pretty much what I have to say on Thanksgiving for now. It's not as I wasn't as eloquent as I would have liked to be for this video, but those are just my general rambling about Thanksgiving. What do you guys think about this holiday? How are you guys spending it? You know, it's a pretty cool time. I, you know, much respect goes out to people who have to work on this holiday. I know my mom has to work on holidays because she's, you know, hospitals are always open. And my mom, I don't think my mom has ever celebrated or has ever gotten a day off on Thanksgiving, except the last couple of years when she wasn't working as a nurse. But other than that, yeah, she's always worked this holiday. So anyway, my heart goes out to people who are working this holiday. But yeah, happy Thanksgiving, happy whatever you celebrate, however you celebrate it. Maybe you don't celebrate it. In that case, I hope you have some days off and enjoy it. So yeah, cheers.